Começam. Se eu cheio me che be mi na ge o. Apo mo ni won cheio e ti o aye. Mo fe mi mo be o si. Mama to bi mi to shala ka mi. Happy birthday mommy Nike, Mrs. Duo Jaye, Olori Laughing. I am going to be saying a little about my mama. I'm not going to be saying all the good parts only. I'll be saying the good and the other aspect she gets. So stay tuned, listen to me and listen to the end, because my mama, she can be something else. So I already said that this year I would not be writing an epistle about my mama. I would rather be saying the epistle, because I feel more I feel better, like I feel good saying it rather than writing it. It feels real saying it. So I don't know where to start from, but I'll just say my mama can be, I don't know, she can be crazy. Actually, she's a very good person. She's a wife, she's a mother, she's a daughter, she's a friend, she's a companion, she's everything you can ever ask for. So, but and she can be a witch. My mama can be really cruel. She can be a bully. Yes, she can be a bully. She used to be a tomboy. Like when you see her, you know that, oh, who is this? Okay, so actually, I don't know, where do I start from? Should I start from the days where when there was nothing, or because I remember when I was young, although I really don't have a retentive memory like that, I forget things easily, but there are still some things that I can never forget in my life. Like I know, like I could remember when we were still very young, all those times. I remember my mom was doing a lot of things together. She's a very hardworking person. To most of you that say, Anima, where did you get your ginger for? It's my mama. When my mama is not working, she's gonna fall sick. Yes, she can fall sick if she's not working. And she's very hardworking and she likes money. Yes, my mama likes money. She likes money like more like a wagon, but she works so hard for her money. So there's nothing you can say about it. And she's a very strong woman, like really strong. Like at times I'll be like, I'll look at her and I'm okay, because most times we call, because okay, like I'm really close to my parents, my mama, my dad. So whenever I'm having a difficult time or anything that's happening to me or anything like that, I call them. It's either I call my dad or I call my mom. And then when I call them, like they reply me, they talk to me, they make me feel better, they make me feel good, they make me even forget my worries. And at times, at the end of the day, I get to know that even they are going through some things, like a lot of things, like in fact something that is even 100 times what me I'm going through, and then they don't show it, and then they still try to give me that support. And one thing about my mama is, even my papa, both of them, whether you fail, whether you succeed or you fail, they will always support you. They will always make you feel like you are the best. No, they don't condemn you. That's one thing about my parents. That's one thing I like about them. They don't condemn. And then I've really troubled my mama a lot. Yeah, to most people that know me, I really used to fall sick a lot when I was, I think when I was in secondary school versus when I gained admission. I'm now a very strong girl. I think that has groomed me, so I'm now very good. So I used to fall sick a lot. Before you know it, Alima, I don't faint. Before you know it, Alima, this. Before you know it, Alima, that. So, boom, my mama, she never, like, she doesn't joke with my health. She doesn't joke with it. I could remember there was one particular time that I was really sick. I was staying off campus, and in my house is I stay in Ibadan, yeah, with my parents, but I stay in school. I don't stay with them since I gained admission. Like my parents are very, very free. They don't force us to do whatever we don't want to do. Whatever you want to do, as long as it's something good, they'll correct them, they'll support you. And if something bad, they'll correct you. But they don't force us that, you know, you must do this, you must do that. They support us with whatever we want to do. So I remember that time I fell sick, and then they called my mom, and my mom rushed down to where I was staying around 1 a.m. It was really crazy. Even though I stay in Ibadan, my place is actually really far from school. I stay in a very rural area like that. And then she drove down to where I was staying that time. I could remember that night she took me to school clinic, and she took me to school clinic, yeah. And then we went back home that particular day. And was it school clinic? I can't even remember, but I sure know she took me to clinic that particular day. And we went back home that day. And then when we are sick, oh my God, my mama is usually the best to stay with her when you are sick. You see, there are some food that when she cooks those food for you, your sickness will go away. I could remember when I was still in secondary school, whenever we have malaria, she usually make us this agbo. Like, I don't know how she makes it with chlorophenicol. I don't know, there's this way she makes it, and then she usually makes us this amala, the amala, because most of our food, my mom makes them from scratch, like our churro, all those things. So she made amala for us, but that amala was mixed with okababa. What's okababa in English? I think millet or so, I'm not sure. So she actually she mixed the eluboy shoe. How would I call eluboy shoe? I don't know eluboy shoe, how do they call it? I don't know. So she mixed the eluboy shoe and the okababa. She mixed them together to make amala for us. And then with one ewedu gold, if my mom make any ewedu for you, like any ewedu she makes for you, trust me, you are good to go. And then that ewedu with egusi gold, after eating it, you forget about your malaria. And then what also should I talk about the time that I was really sick? I remember when I had my appendicitis operation. Oh my God, that particular day. In fact, whenever I fall sick, even if it's just headache, I tell people not to call my mama unless it is serious, because if you call her, hey, we are going to fall that sickness together. So that particular time, so that particular time she rushed down, because I was actually transferred from school clinic to UCH, University College Hospital Ibadan. So she rushed down to UCH. Go, like, remember, as I was crying, my mom was crying with me. I was like, mommy, I don't want to die. Mommy, I don't want to die. My mom was crying. My baby, you will not die. And I could also remember when the doctor announced that they were going to operate me. And then I was like, oh my God, what's it called? Mom was like, oh, you feel like that? No, she started praying, different things like that. And then even I can remember during the time I was admitted at the hospital, because our guardian or parents were not allowed to stay with us, so we were so anything to I think around 10 or so, they'll send them away. So my mama could not leave me, and so she was always staying with me in the hospital, UCH. Most people, if you know UCH, you know what I'm talking about. So she made sure she was staying, like, she was always sleeping inside our car. That place was very, very close to my window. I think my ward was upstairs, and then she had to park our car downstairs, but very, very close to my window where I was staying. And then she was sleeping inside the car throughout my admission at the hospital. And it was really crazy, because later I got to know that where my mama was actually staying, where she was sleeping at that time, it was very close to a mortuary, to UCH mortuary. And then that time when she, oh my God, I mean, because that particular time, that day we went to UCH, then when she showed me, I was like, mama, are you kidding me? This is where they carry corpse up and down, and then this was where you were sleeping. She was like, what do I do? I could not leave you. Do you get? I was like, oh my God. And during that time, she was seriously sick. She had this, should I say, knee problem. She still has it though. And then when you, like, for those that know UCH, she will always go up and down. She was always going up and down to get my scan results, this and that. And then she was doing all of this. It was after I got better that she now fell sick again due to all the stress and everything. A whole lot of things. Like, my mama can sacrifice herself for any of her children. Like, she's just everything. Like, in fact, I don't even know how many do I want to say. Okay, even I could remember the first location that I went to, my mama actually took me there. Like, can you imagine my mama taking me to a location? The first time I go to a location, that was in Oyo, and my mama came to stay with me there. Like, she spent money on the cast and crew, that those people were even respecting me, giving me this. It got to a point that I was like, mama, come and be going home. I went to a location, my mama rented a hotel for me to stay. Like, can you imagine, for those of you that know about theater, like, we newbies, we don't get that luxury, sure you get. And then, like, everybody, I was like, Mama, you will not let me learn what I'm supposed to learn with all those things you are doing. And then, okay, later she just had to just leave me alone. And then also, I could remember when she was also the one that registered me at J15 then. A whole lot of things, like, oh God, you see. I don't know. All I just know is I'm really blessed to have my parents, my papa, daddy Nike, and my mama, mommy Nike. And mommy Nike can be something that she's a Malian. Yeah, she's a Malian. Malians for life. When you ask mommy Nike, I'm a Malian. So, and then she seeks all the hip hop that even me, her daughter, I don't know. My mama Sabian. My mama is much more fashionable than I am when she's making up, when she's taking care of herself. She goes to gym. Who does that? My mama swims. I don't even know how to swim. I don't even know your life. In fact, God, I don't even know. All I just know is God should bless her for me. God bless you, mommy. Thank you for everything. Thank you for being who you are. Thank you for being the best mom. I really appreciate it. Thank you so much. God bless you. I love you. Happy birthday, mama. Mwah.